company has more than three personals. Number of players with three. Vincent trying to pull the foul, goes down hard. And going to count the foul before any shot attempt.
What is that?
Eric Spoelstra's trying to say he was shooting. And now they're in the penalty. 9:17 remaining. So it's going to be two free throws because they called a foul before the upward motion.
How is that a foul anyway?
Putting Bam in position to read all the action of the shooters and the small bird that got the run around him. And what he is, besides a unique passer and a playmaker,
that's not no foul.
He's a big time screen setter.
He sure is.
22 for Vincent. That foul on Caldwell Pope is fourth.
And this is where Denver's got to regain their poise. They're spending a lot of time being frustrated with how the calls are going. They've just got to play better basketball right now.
Miami with a little pressure, but it falls back into the zone. So it eats up plenty of clock. A 13-point turnaround here in less than 3 minutes in the fourth. Jokic fouled, shot no good. But he'll get to the line. He's taken six free throws already.
I think they're going to call it before the shot.
Okay, so side out. Vincent now with four fouls. So now we have one player on each team with four. Caldwell Pope finds Jokic behind the back. Touchdown LA. Running shot. No good, but a foul.
My goodness.
One up in the back, in the paint, with a defender around him. And a Bile, a little frustrated there. He's a point guard. I don't care how you just, he is a point guard. Behind the back, takes the contact, just a skill level. And the discussion to me when you watch him, we've had the privilege to watch him now. I already said early in the year, he's a top 10 center all the time. Question is, where does he fit? Because he's clearly in there, without a doubt. He's one of the most unique players. I thought Darvin Ham had an interesting description of him. As he said, he has a little bit of McHale, Kevin McHale, and a little bit of Larry Bird in his game. 3-point Miami lead. Just over 3 minutes gone by, fourth quarter. Heat trying to even up these finals. At one game apiece in hand, Denver, their first home loss in these playoffs. Lowry, Adebayo jumper, got it. The Heat 6-for-6 from the field here in the fourth quarter.
And when they score, they're able to fall back into their zone.
Again, Denver led by 8 coming into the fourth. Brown drives, can't get it. Tip by Adebayo, Robinson. Cradles it, and they do a great job in the zone, not allowing Jokic to catch the basketball at the free throw line, because that's where they get trouble. Here's Robinson. Martin to Vincent. Vincent fires away. In and out. And Jokic with his 10th rebound. And a foul on Duncan Robinson away from the play where Gordon got tripped up. His second foul.
Well, again, the two-man game right here. Lowry comes off, finds the pocket to Adebayo. That's a not an easy shot, but Bam Adebayo shoots it right down the middle.
So Jamal Murray, just 10 points, 4/10 on the field, a quiet offensive game, but we've seen Murray erupt. As Butler will check back in with Murray. And that's when they're at their best. Jamal Murray is scoring alongside of Jokic, taking the pressure off him. That's why Jimmy Butler comes back into the ballgame. Make sure you have a bigger body on. Porter, a contested three. That won't go. Caleb Martin with the rebound. Adebayo to Butler. Butler's been distributing. Leads the team with 8 assists. Turns it over. Ball just slipped out of his hands. Caldwell Pope to Murray. Murray back to Caldwell Pope.
Great effort and transition defense by Miami.
Jokic telling him to get it. Inside, catches, turns, shoots, and scores. 35 points for Nikola Jokic.
And Jimmy Butler's had a rough night shooting. But right now, as this goes down the stretch, he's got to come through.
looking. Jokic playing off him. Robinson trying to find an opening. Butler, corner three. It's good. Jimmy Butler, his second three-pointer of the game. The lead back up to six. And falling back into the zone. A big shot by Jimmy Butler. They're 16 of 31 from three-point range. The Heat, 52% from downtown. Caldwell pulled back up top. Murray. Murray on the drive. Off balance. Back shot is good.
Some good ass game.
Butler goes back door, but out of bounds to the Delta.
And the reason is that Jokic is sagging more off out of bounds to try to prevent those passes into the paint.
Out of bounds catches, kicks it out in the corner. Butler on the drive, the floater is good, and the foul. Well, Jeff, just like you said, all of a sudden Butler now very aggressive, looking for a shot. And a chance for a three-point play. You got to do a better job defensively closing out of your Gordon. Live with him shooting it when it contests, allows him to get by him. Butler takes the contact, hits the mid-range. In the previous play, this is a big-time shot. Find a way to score and keep the pressure on the Nuggets. Jimmy Butler hits the three. And completes the three-point play. Largest lead of the second half for Miami. They led by 11 in the opening minutes, and then a great turnaround. Denver went up by 15. Now it's the Heat, a 7-point advantage. Murray inside, Jokic turns and scores.
The ball hits the rim so softly when Jokic shoots. It just, some guys have a knack for falling in, and other guys, it rattles out.
Robinson trying to get free. Caldwell Pope trying to smother him. Eight to shoot for Lowry. Long three-pointer. And a foul on the three-pointer tip. Caldwell Pope can't believe it. That's five on him. I think he's trying to see that Lowry kicked. Caldwell Pope upset. And that's a foul.
Yep.
And think about it, that's six free throws that Caldwell Pope has given up fouling the three-point shooter.